Colonel, and I am a little jittery, but I so am excited to be here tonight with you all. And if I can see you, I can tell that we have a full house, so I'm super excited about that as well. And if you hear the pitter-patter behind me, it's because the guys are filling the stage, because they are even more nervous than I am, which is hilarious. They're so cute when they get nervous like this. The video that you watched is kind of a... Is that me? The video that you watched was kind of an overview of our Clash of Classes experience that we, through Leadership Dynamics... that we were able to put on thanks to programs like this where we raised some money. So thank you for buying a ticket. Thank you for coming. Thank you for being here tonight and supporting us in our quest to build a culture in this building that makes students want to be here. Because when they want to be here, we're going to get their best. And if we get their best, then there's the ripple effect that we cannot even imagine. So you're not going to hear from me all night because we know how to put on a show. And with that, that means we have the best master of ceremonies in all of Henderson County. Put your hands together and help me welcome, no stranger to the stage or microphone, the voice of Henderson, Steve Powell.
Ladies and gentlemen, good evening. It is my pleasure to be here for the third annual Mr. Colonel event. This is the third one I've had the opportunity to MC. We have been promoting it all week on the Keeping Up with the Colonel edition of the Steve Towel Morning Show at WSON. It is our honor at WSON to be affiliated with such a fine contest. Now with that, I will turn to my co-host and ask, based on the amount of rehearsal time and the two dress rehearsals on a scale of 1 to 10, how is this performance going to turn out?
It's anybody's guess. This will be maybe the second time that all 13 contestants are able to do this together in one spot. We want to give a shout out to how busy they all really are. But that's okay, and that's what I told them. This is about having fun and taking advantage of yet one more senior year experience, having the best time, because guess what? They're the ones that are here tonight. They're the ones that we're going to get to smile and laugh and make these memories, and at the end of the day, that's what it's all about.
I would like to take this opportunity, the first of a couple of times that I will mention, my good friend and our good friend, Pam Fister-Clark at Gallery Gifts and Bridal. She allowed me to wear a tuxedo for the first time since June 4th, 1994. That was the day that I got married, almost 28 years ago. And again, that is at Gallery Gifts and Bridal on Main Street in Henderson. And again, thank you so much to Pim Fister-Clark to help make this happen, the male version of the little black dress, as they say. How about a big hand for Miss Snowballs out there tonight? Yeah, right? 28 years worth.
28 years he's taken, but man, you do clean up.
Yeah.
Not what he wears on the radio in the morning.
No, it is not. It is definitely not. And I'm lucky to have on glasses tonight, because for tonight I'd like to see. Right now I'm looking into an abyss of darkness. So again,
I think there are people
I don't
there.
Know if there are 20 people here or 145 people here. But again, we are super excited and so glad that you came out to join us here tonight. Jennifer, what do we have going on tonight? What are the three areas that we're going to be looking at?
What do you want to do?
With me, as you can tell, physically, I'm all about fitness, right?
I say we get some pizza and we just kick back.
Yeah.
No, you mean the guys.
No, I do this.
Okay, we're going to kick the night off with a group dance. Then we're going to move into the talent portion. And yes, they all have a talent. Or so they think. But that's okay. Then the best part of the evening is when they get all dressed up and they escort their moms out onto the stage. Super just chivalrous of them, so that's kind of cool. And then after all of that, we're going to, well, during that part, they're going to get to answer a question on stage. And we gave them the questions, although it was in their email.
Yeah.
We had to tell them where their email was. No, it's funny. So they have practiced, they're ready, they're prepared, they're not nervous, and we're going to give them some scores.
Yes, we will. So now let's give a warm welcome. Here they are to perform a Valentine's Day theme routine for a fitness portion of the competition. Here are the contests, or contestants, I should say, of this year's Mr. Colonel. Show of hands. Yes, that is going to be the QR for the voting directions is on the program.
So what we're going to do with the QR on the program, and I know it's dark, but during intermission, this will be one of the last awards that we give out. You scan the QR code and there'll be a drop-down menu, and you as a crowd get to give out an award tonight and choose your favorite contestant. And so I think it's going to ask you to log into your account. We were working through the Wi-Fi and all, but we're going to, fingers crossed that it works this year because we didn't get to do it last year. But that's how the QR code is going to work. And then we also have the Best Legs contest going on out in the lobby.
Okay. No silent option?
Nope.
Okay. We also asked, very important, please refrain from moving while the contestants are performing on stage. That would help a great deal. I would like to now have you meet our three judges for this evening. First, Kyle Sticks Forster. From the class of 2002, he went on to graduate from Western Kentucky University in 2007 with a Bachelor of Science in Business Management and a minor in Marketing. Kyle is beginning his 14th year working for Gribbins Insulation, where he is now the Vice President of the Southern Region, which oversees the operations for their Louisville, Nashville, and Paducah offices. He has been an avid supporter of Henderson County High School and is currently in the middle of his 11th season as assistant basketball coach for the boys basketball team. In his free time, Cal enjoys spending his time with friends and family, as well as watching sports. He is married to Lindsay Forster and has a 12-year-old stepson, Colby Sutton. And his favorite teacher of all time, of course, say it with me, Miss Ginger Stovall. Ladies and gentlemen, Kyle Forster. Our next judge is Dr. Michelle Chappelle. Michelle Chappelle is an alumnus of Henderson County High School from the class of 1991. She is an associate professor in the Computer and Information Technologies program at Henderson Community College. Also, she is the program coordinator for the Computer and Information Technologies program and coordinator of Diversity, Equity, and Inclusion. She is a mentor to underrepresented minority students at Henderson Community College and in the Henderson community to assist with closing the achievement gap. Lastly, she obtained her doctoral of education specialization in adult and higher education leadership from Morehead State University. I didn't know we had that in common. She loves reading, music, no country, I mind you, binge watching on Netflix, and is a lifelong Steelers fan. Ladies and gentlemen, Dr. Michelle Chappelle. And our third judge is Mr. Josh Bennett. If you can dream it, you can do it. And that's exactly what has happened to Josh. Josh Bennett was born and raised here in Henderson County, and after many years of owning and running cutting edge lawn and landscape, he decided to chase his dream of owning and operating a restaurant. In January of 2021, he took the first step of making this dream a reality and opened Chef What, Barbecue and More. Josh and his wife, Amy, really enjoy the opportunities that has given them to give back to the community that they love so very much. Ladies and gentlemen, Josh Bennett. Okay, now for the talent portion. The talent portion will hopefully prove to be one of the most entertaining parts of the show. They will sing, dance, act, make you laugh, and no doubt impress you with their unique and very creative talents. Please hold your applause until the end of each performance, but don't forget to cheer on all of your favorites. Remember, your favorite talent, as you will be able to cast your vote using your smartphone and QR code in the program. And with that, our first talent of the evening is contestant number one, Cole Parrish. He has been a student of percussion genre of music for 7 years, falling in love with drums in the sixth grade. Why, you ask? Because they are the loudest instrument, of course. Sponsored by ERA First Advantage Realty, here is Cole Parrish performing a marimba solo. Thank you. Our next contestant is number 3, Brecken Sauer. As one of the sports anchors of the Colonelcast News, Brecken is very familiar being behind the anchor desk. Here he is tonight to dazzle us with his talent of being able to read from a teleprompter and deliver the news. Sponsored by Sauer Farms, here is contestant number 3, Brecken Sauer.
To work smoothly, we needed to switch contestant number 2 with number 3 so that we could get the marimba off stage and then get contestant number 2 ready. So we know. So judges, you want to switch? Did you get it? So we're good. Good?
All right. Good deal.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, here he is, contestant number 3, Brecken Sauer.
It is decision day at the University of Southern Indiana. The Screaming Eagles are now preparing to make one big leap from Division II to Division I. Thank you for joining me. I'm Brecken Sauer. USI's president, Dr. Robert Shawn, says that the move from Division II to Division I is one of the most significant changes that the university has ever made. It's also one of the most impactful changes since gaining statewide independence nearly 4 decades ago. Monday's vote means that USI will apply to the NCAA cause of suffocation. And if that's approved, they will start playing in the conference beginning in the fall of 22. The Eagles will be playing in the Ohio Valley Conference. USI will be the 23rd full-time member in the 74-year history of the Ohio Valley Conference. Now on to the big question that many students have for the university. Will the cost of tuition rise? Yes. This move will cost some additional funding. The cost of tuition will gradually go up during a 4-year period from $60 per semester to as much as $238 a semester in the 2025-2026 school year. As a part of the upcoming student body, I'm actually very excited to see the Screaming Eagles play against bigger D1 schools throughout the country. That's it for this very short story about the great Screaming Eagles. I'm Brecken Sauer. Go Colonels. Charge on.
Brecken Sauer. Our next performance is by contestant number 2, Breck Bender. Breck has tapped into the unfamiliar talent of painting, thanks to Mrs. Grace. Needing a talent for the event, he did what any of us talentless folks would have done. He phoned a friend, then Googled it. Maybe his debut performance with a paintbrush tonight will launch him into a career field none of us saw coming. Maybe it'll be the first and a lasting painting impression, or experience, I should say. Judges, that's your call. Sponsored by Square Yard Carpet, please help me welcome contestant number 2, Breck Bender.
Thank you.
doubting my dog, did
no,
you?
No, not for one second. Yeah. And when he says inexperienced, he took that to another level.
He said an easel?
An easel, yeah.
Easel?
Exactly.
There's going to be an easel?
Yeah. As you could tell through all the past performances, he had not used an easel.
What easel?
And we thought about winging it in the moment. So there you go.
Bless him.
How much fun are we having so far? Just getting started. There's some things going on in the hallway out there that defy explanation, and we're going to let that take care of itself when they take it to the stage.
Admin, we'll get to watch the film back on the cameras.
Yeah, so anything that happens in the hallway is obviously being documented even as we speak. Our next performer will be contestant number 4, Hayden Emick. Word on the street, Ms. Stovall, is that Hayden should have stolen the page from the book of Breck when it comes to searching for his talent. Phone a friend and Google it.
I think he did, which is how he ended up here.
Yeah. Thank you. When faced with this challenge, he opted to try magic tricks, making his debut in his quest to follow, well, pick a magician.
But do you know a magician? Can you
Bert
name?
Bert Wonderstone.
Okay, you win.
There's two people I know what I'm talking about.
It's
not
like
no. Anyway, sponsored by Chapel Heating and Air, ladies and gentlemen, contestant number 4, Hayden Emick.
Alright, so, good evening. Have any of y'all ever seen a quarter disappear? So, what if I told you I could make one disappear? Watch. And then whenever I pull this cloth off, it's gonna disappear. You ready? All right, so for this next trick, I'm gonna need a $20 bill from someone in the crowd. Is there anyone willing to offer up some money?
No.
$20, come on, man.
I want it back.
All right. Okay, for this next trick, I'm gonna make this $20 bill disappear. So, are you ready? Watch. I've been practicing that trick for like 16 some odd years, so I've gotten pretty good at it. That's all I got. Thank you.
$20.25 that disappeared, don't forget.
Hey Steve, guess what I have?
No sound. There you go. That's better. Yeah, now we're good. Yes, what do you have?
This is the only one in existence, the Mr. Colonel medal, that this year's Mr. Colonel is going to get to wear at graduation. Isn't that kind of neat?
Very cool.
This happened, and it has the kernel on it, you can see, and the year, so it is the
No, I'm sorry.
What did you just...
I bid it. I want to make sure if it's authenticity. No?
Sorry, everybody. Yeah.
Yeah, we are.
So, with that being said, we have, as you see across the front of the stage, all of the decorations. They're really the prizes, and shout out to the Leadership Dynamics class for working so hard. Empty-handed, so that will save us a surprise for later.
I want one of those car wash tokens I got last year.
Ooh, is there a car wash token in your future?
We'll see. All right, folks, contestant number 5, Jaden Deibler, when challenged with coming up with his best talent, Jaden spent time self-exploring, realizing his strength and talent lies in eating. I think a lot of us can identify. And he resolved to eating. Wait for it, folks. Cereal. But what does one wear when showcasing and eating talent. Ladies and gentlemen, sponsored by Gibbons Counseling, or Consulting, I should say, contestant number 5 is Jaden Deibler. But I don't know where to start.
The crowd wants to know, was that your Spider-Man outfit?
It was, from 1987. Still fits. My right foot.
Save the joke telling, if you will.
Yeah, exactly. Well, we've got that coming up.
We've
got that in tall order coming up in a few minutes. Is Once Upon a Time at Summer FFA Camp. Contestant number 6 was a competent colonel and finally disclosed one of his passions on a public platform.
Pause right there.
Okay.
You ready?
Yep.
Shout out to the FFA Club.
Oh, yeah. Woo!
And that wasn't for you.
You know what FFA stands for. What does it stand for? FFA.
Because they changed it.
They took out because...
Oh, it wasn't a trick question.
No, it was not a trick question. I'm not smart enough to bear those. So, each chapter had to bring a performance to the camp show, and our Henderson County High School chapter brought Travis and his hidden talent.
True.
He's gonna prove it in a big way, I promise you. Instead of performing on his own YouTube channel tonight, he is ready for his family to watch him take to the stage and make them proud. Telling dad jokes, sponsored by Silver Creek Transportation. Here he is. Travis Herndon, contestant.
Is it
working?
Yeah.
Okay, so I think before we proceed any further, because obviously I'm doing dad jokes, we must first establish, when does a dad joke actually become a dad joke? No, it's when it becomes apparent. Why couldn't the bicycle stand up on its own? It was too tired. So, I was out playing in the park the other day, and I kept wondering why this frisbee kept looking bigger and bigger. Then it hit me! So, yesterday, about the same time, I hit a clock. It was very time consuming. Especially when I went back for seconds. So, whenever I try and eat healthy, a chocolate bar always looks at me and snickers. Why is Peter Pan always flying? Because he never lands. Someone complimented my parking today. They left this really sweet note on my windshield that said, "Parking fine." Did you hear about the kidnapping in school? It's fine, he woke up. Yeah, he didn't miss the bell. What do you call a fish with two knees? No, a toonie fish. And I'm going to leave y'all tonight with, I've used this joke twice now, both times it has absolutely killed. Why didn't the toilet paper cross the road? It got stuck in a dirty crack.
The bar has now been set very high, and Travis is the guy that's setting it. I can see the other ones reaching.
Are you asking for his email so that he can bring you up to speed on
yeah.
all your
Yeah,
podcasts?
So I can ask. I need absolute content, and he certainly can serve as a writer in that category. Our seventh contestant to perform tonight's talent portion is H.B. Hazelwood. At the young age of 9, H.B.'s mom felt he would be a natural pianist and quickly enrolled him in piano lessons.
Wouldn't that have been cute?
Oh, my God. Thank goodness we didn't own a piano. This didn't turn into his passion, but sure fit the need when he needed a talent for this show. H.B. has always been inspired by Snoop Dogg, who hasn't.
How did you go from piano to Snoop Dogg?
I
wrote it.
Exactly. You're the one who wrote it. We should ask you that. He taught himself one of his songs, and he will play that tonight, playing Still Dre by Snoop Dogg, sponsored by E.M. Ford. Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number 7, H.B. Hazelwood. Schedule tomorrow. I've had more excitement out of the crowd than when
now you lost.
In reacting today. Exactly. Oh my goodness. An art performance tonight is contestant number 9. That is Tyler May. Being a lookalike as Justin Bieber, or so he thinks, it was just as given his words, not ours, that he would bring his talent to the show and sing the song choice. It's one you will sing along with, so get ready for this. Ladies and gentlemen, sponsored by Allstate Insurance, Deep Agency, and no stranger to the stage when performing, contestant number 9, Tyler May, with his first try.
We're in his way.
And Justin, well, he's gonna have to wait. Justin Bieber, give it up. Tyler May!
I know you care, shall we never and I'll be there. You are my love, you are my heart, and we will never, ever, ever be apart. Are we an idol? Girl, quit playing. We're just friends, what are you saying? That there's another look right in my eyes. My first love broke my heart for the first time.
Contested, will sing one of his songs. Will has been playing the guitar for 7 years, and this song happens to be one of his favorites. He is combining the two for us tonight, sponsored by Edmunds Woodworking, and here to perform Feeling Whitney by Post Malone, contestant number 10, Will Forker!
No mic! Ooh, 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 ooh.
I've been looking for someone to put up with my boo. I can't even win my bed. And I ain't seen the light of day since last night in Portland. It's been long. And I was feeling with me, yet my homie said he was still. Causing clothes, thought I was winning. You knew I was losing. Told me to wake up on my clock. Oh, it stays, I'm snoozing. I'm done. Chair on in, from peace and knowing, ain't no always broken, but it is the hoping, show no emotion, and getting you coding, just act as hard as you can, you don't need a friend, boy you're the man. Ooh.
Said, Ms. Ginger Stovall will announce our next pair of contestants.
So you may have noticed that our order was a little out of sync there again, but that's because this duo chose to perform together. So number eight, contestant number 8 and 11 are going to pair up.
Ha!
See what I did there?
Yeah.
Okay. Travis, he tells some good
things. He's good. It's everlasting.
Okay, these two have been the best of friends since they began playing soccer together in elementary school. And if they are that talented on the soccer field, then they must be equally as talented on this stage, right?
Yes.
Whatever the case may be, they agree that they are truly having the time of their lives.
You did.
And to prove it, sponsored by Audubon Dental and McElroy Farms, here are contestants 8 and 11, judges, Xander Wilson, and Boone McElroy.
Show some love!
Oh!
Xander and Boone will be available for party bookings after this tonight. Who knew?
How do we follow that?
I don't know, but Xander looks wonderful in fuchsia.
Certainly does. And little lips.
That part of the crowd, there must be a gas leak right there.
Or a roof leak.
One or the other. It's affecting certain areas of the crowd. And that's okay. We're here to have a good time tonight. Are we having a good time tonight?
We told you it would be the best $5 they've spent lately.
Absolutely.
So thank you again, crowd and audience.
All right, here we are. Our 12th contestant of the talent portion. Number 12 is Dylan Moore, a natural performer of hip-hop and one to always entertain. Dylan jumped at the opportunity to take to the stage again.
Again.
I mean, if the Evansville Iceman enjoyed it, why shouldn't we? Sponsored by Farmer Performing to the mix of great hits. Here is Dylan. Get jiggy with it! Contestant of the talent portion is contestant 13, Drew Kaser. Drew has enlisted in the Army National Guard and completed basic training during the summer between his junior and senior year. Congratulations
that
on that.
That means he's employed right now.
That means he's in shape.
He's been making money going to school.
Is that right? Wish I'd done that when I worked here. Tonight, for his talent, he will demonstrate how to successfully assist a fallen comrade who has been wounded on the battlefield. Here is contestant number 13, Drew Kaser, with the casualty crawl. Give it up.
This I transport a wounded foot comrade. He weighs 125, I weigh 130. And in my rucksack, I got between 70 to 80 pounds.
It's hard. It's hard to keep your spirits together. It's hard. 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 You're earning. But it's worth it. It's worth believing. It's worth fighting. You can do it. You can do it. It's not the potential of the individual. It's not the genetics. It's the perseverance. The never say die attitude. We all fall down in life. The question is, who gets back up? If you constantly keep pulling the strings of the wall, some guys have worked and other guys have worked. It's about what you're made out of, not the circumstances.
Every single one of you who is struggling right now, you need to understand this.
what you're going through right now.
Alright, that concludes the talent portion of tonight's show. We would like to ask the moms of the contestants to please head to the lobby and meet Maggie at this time.
Maggie Moore will be out there waiting for you, and I'll be out there momentarily. Meanwhile, now is your opportunity, audience. Get your QR code out if you haven't done so already, because we're giving you the chance to pick your favorites so far. I understand if you want to wait a little bit longer, but now you only get to vote one time using your QR code because phone's lighting.
I know, right?
People here, right. Steve.
Yeah, I want to say congratulations on you folks being the largest crowd that we've had up in 3 years. I want to say maybe tonight's crowd might be the equivalent of seasons one and two.
Combined,
absolutely.
So look at them. They're discussing and they're voting. They're excited.
And, of course, tomorrow morning, Ginger will be back on again, and we'll have the winner of the Mr. Colonel event that will be on the show at 6:30 tomorrow morning at 96.5 FM at 860 AM WSON. It'll be on C-Town, the morning show. We'll have that winner tonight. That's the kind of the paradox.
We can tell them that part.
Yeah, the paradox of winning is that you get to win one night and wake up early the next morning and then still have a full day of school on a Friday. But it's usually a lot of fun, and we'll talk about the preparation that it went into winning the Mr. Colonel event, as well as how excited they are to get up early and profess that they are a winner.
You hear them?
I do. I think they're discussing amongst themselves their voting options. And again, take the opportunity to vote now, because again, you hate for it to come down to maybe your vote and your favorite performer, and you thought, you know what, I'll just let everybody else vote, and that's how other people win.
You see how you hope they're listening, but maybe they're not, and how teaching a class would go?
I have completely lost the room. And that's okay, that's fine, that's it. We'll all be home in about an hour and a half, whatever it is, 2 hours, whatever. So again, looking forward to it. Now you also, again, we are so proud again to have with us Dr. Michelle Chappell. Thank you so much, dear. I've worked with your son, okay?
Not my son.
He's not?
He doesn't claim to.
He's not your son tonight. Okay, because I am going to speak to him. I'm going to speak to him. Maybe as soon as I leave the stage. But again, we're so glad to have you here tonight. Kyle, you were sitting in the same two spots like last year, like maybe last year, the year before. Have you left?
I just hung out.
You just used to hang out. Josh is normally in bed in about, what, 30 minutes?
Ago.
Yeah, you know, I'm sorry, about 6:30. You know, because pulled pork is not going to smoke itself, is it? Absolutely. Tomorrow's special? Queso?
Queso.
All right, queso tomorrow. Okay, very good. Very good. Of course, my co-host has abandoned me, and I don't know anymore. I know one dad joke, but I really don't feel like it's something that you would appreciate. I want to tell it anyway. Guy walks into his psychiatrist's office and says, "Doctor, I'm a wigwam, I'm a teepee, I'm a wigwam, I'm a teepee." And the doctor says, "Relax, you're too tense." Thank you. I told you it was bad, and I prefaced it by being bad. I apologize. I own that joke. I have no problem with that. I figured you would. Again, I want to another shout out to our good friend at WSON, Pam Pfister Clark with Gallery Gifts and Bridal. Thank you for the sign, ladies. That's so very nice. Thank you. Yeah. Did you make one for Ms. Stovall? Say no. Ah, dang it. But anyway, thank you again for that, ladies. That's very, very sweet of you. But I'd just like to say, again, Gallery Gifts and Bridal, fantastic. You got prom coming up, hopefully about 10 years down the road. You've got a wedding coming up. They got bridal gowns, tuxedos, dinner jackets, you name it. Gallery Gifts and Bridal, Main Street here in Henderson. Ginger, where are we at now?
I have checked in. We have some beautiful moms out there. We have some nice-looking young men. I think we're ready, Steve. Backstage, are we ready? Are they listening?
Can we get the curtains open, please? Okay, Cole, if you would. Cole, let me ask you something. Are you nervous?
No, sir, not at all.
All right, that's what I want to hear. Cole, tell us about the teacher who made the biggest impact on your educational experience.
That would have to be Miss Amanda Joyner, my AP biology teacher. She taught me when things get tough, you know, when classes and stuff like that get tough, just to keep on pushing through and study hard and you'll get where you need to go.
Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number one, Cole Alexander Parrish. Thank you for your subtlety. Contestant number two, escorted by his lovely mother, Carla. Contestant number two is Brett Patrick Bender. Also known as Chris Matter. Greg is the son of Patrick and Carly. He's a member of the Student Council, Leadership Dynamics, National Technical Honor Society, the golf team, and is an ambassador. Greg is the senior class president, Mr. Senior and Kamiana King. Greg was voted on by his peers and was named as best leader for the class of 2022 and says his favorite color is maroon and white, of course. After graduation, Brett plans to attend USI to major in accounting. The most recent show he binged was Last Chance U, and his idea of the perfect date, picking her up, taking her to a restaurant where we meet up with all the boys to see if they approve. If they do, then take her home and plan another date. Oh, and shake her father's hand, of course. Brett, if you would. Which of the yearly hashtags has inspired you the most and why? Hashtag make a wave, hashtag design your destination, hashtag press play, or hashtag the time is now?
Well, Steve, my answer to that would be hashtag press play. Me and my fellow student council members here worked real hard over summer to determine that would be our slogan this year. And, you know, it was good to get with them over summer a lot and it meant a lot. And we just kind of built things around that through the year to make it music-based, and it was a lot to me.
Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number two, Brett Patrick Lewis Bender. Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number three, escorted by his lovely mother, Melissa, is Brecken Michael Exquisite Sauer.
Yeah, big strong!
Brecken is the son of John and Melissa Sauer. Brecken is an ambassador, a member of the Leadership Dynamics class, Colonel Cast News, and the Y Club. He's also a senior varsity football player. Mr. Sauer plans to attend USI, where he will major in broadcast television and radio. Looking over my shoulder. One fun fact about Brecken, one time he totaled his car on the way to his 18th birthday dinner. Well done, sir. He most recently binged Yellowstone and his idea of a perfect date. Take her to her favorite restaurant, pay for her dinner, and after that, do whatever she wants to do, because in the end, it doesn't matter what guys want. It's always what girls want, because guys are never right. Okay. Reckon, if you would. Thank you. Tell us about a challenge you faced here at Henderson County High School and how you were able to overcome it.
Well, Steve, I'd have to go with COVID. I know COVID impacted a lot of people. It took away half of my sophomore year and like most of my junior year. And it's a very big challenge for, I think, everyone that went to school here and every teacher, faculty, and a board member. So I just studied my best, got it on my Google Meets, and tried to keep my grades up as best as I could, and so did everyone else.
Ladies and gentlemen, Reckon Michael Sauer. Escorted by his lovely mother, Diana. Contestant number four is Hayden Nicholas Inquisitive Emick. He is the son of Alan and Diana Emick. Hayden is a member of the Emick's Colonel Crew and serves as an ambassador. After graduation, Hayden plans to attend UK to major in biology. His favorite color is orange, and his most recent binge watching was to Yellowstone. Hayden's idea of a perfect date, getting dinner and going for a walk. Hayden, if you would. All right. Hayden, if you could have any superhuman power, what would it be and why?
Well, I would have to go with the infinite knowledge, because I could solve a lot of the world's problems and do a lot of things.
It's a great answer. Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen. Hayden Nicholas. Escorted by his lovely mother, Jill, contestant number five is Jaden Eric Tall Dibler. Jaden is the son of Gerald and Jill Dibler. He is on the automotive pathway of the CTE unit after graduation. Jaden plans to continue working as a mechanic to save money to go to auto school. Fun fact about Jaden, he has three tattoos. His idea of the perfect date, to be outside fishing with some good food. All right. Jaden, if you would. What is the best thing about living in Henderson?
I think the best thing about living in Henderson is it's a small town, but it's kind of big, so there's a lot of area to cover and a lot of stuff to do around the town. The Mexican restaurants are really good, but it's small, so there's a lot of local businesses, and there's a lot of people that'll help you out, and a lot of nice people, and everyone's neighborly to each other.
Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number five, Jaden Eric Dibler. Travis is the son of Preston and Tiffany Herndon. He is a member of FFA and the bass fishing team. This fall, Travis plans to attend Eastern Kentucky University to major in business management. Fun fact about Travis, he has his own YouTube channel. Most recently, Travis binge-watched The Witcher. His favorite color is green. And his idea of a perfect date, he packs a picnic and takes her fishing. All right, Travis, if you can do it. If you could go back in time, what advice would you give your middle school self as you come back to high school?
Okay. So the advice that I would give myself is probably do not be afraid to try new things and go outside of your comfort zone. Because my freshman year, I was not willing to participate in any clubs. I really tried to get out of doing anything extracurricular related. I just wanted to go to school, go home, be done with it. And then sophomore year, I was really pushed by a certain someone to get more involved in the FFA, and it really helped me to grow as a person. And because of that, I'm actually able to be on here, and I could have talked, but not made any sense. So now I can at least talk, and you know what I'm saying. So I've grown a lot as a person, made a lot of new friends, and really learned how to present myself.
Ladies and gentlemen, H.P. Well-Rounded Hazelwood. H.P. is the son of Mike and Jonda Hazelwood. He's a member of the FBLA, the golf team, and serves as an ambassador. This fall, you will find H.P. at Ole Miss, majoring in mechanical engineering. His favorite color is baby blue, and his zodiac sign is Aries. One fun fact about H.P., he has chipped his tooth 11 times. Recently, H.P. has been watched Friday Night Lights, and his idea of the perfect date, Krispy Kreme hot and ready with that special someone. HB, if you would. Who is the family member that has the greatest influence on you?
Well, that has to be my sister. She always tells me what's cool and kind of what's not cool, and stops me from doing some dumb things. So I'd have to say Esty.
Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number 7, Hugh Patrick H.B. Hazelwood. Escorted by his lovely mother, Crystal, contestant number 8 is Xander Owen Athlete Wilson. Xander is the son of Damian and Crystal Wilson. He's a member of the boys' soccer team and basketball team. His plans after high school are yet to be determined, but does include playing soccer at the next level. Fun fact about Xander, he has played 2 sports his whole life. Recently, he just watched On My Block. His favorite color is blue. His idea of the perfect day, making your own meal that you'll both enjoy, and then watch a movie at your own crib. Go ahead. I'll ask you the questions if it's okay. If you could, what is the one thing you would change to improve Henderson County High School? What's that? No, came from another. Take something that you might not appreciate about the school. What would make it better? And you can't say the size of the school. Can't do anything about it.
More, less homework.
More, less homework. I like that.
The food, definitely. That's all I got.
That's good enough for me, ladies and gentlemen. A big hand, Sandra Owen Wilson. Contestant number 9 is Tyler Joshua Jeremy Outgoing May. Tyler is the son of Elise May and Jeremy May. He's a member of Colonel's Corner Bank, FBLA, SOFA Theater, and Colonel Crew. This fall, Tyler plans to major in business marketing at the University of Kentucky. Fun fact about Tyler, he is 12.5% Lebanese. His favorite color is blue, and his most recent binge is Daredevil and Cobra Kai. Tyler's idea of the perfect date, his words, quote, as cliche as it sounds, any date I go on is a perfect date as long as I'm with my girlfriend, unquote. All right, Tyler, if you would. What has been your favorite high school experience?
There's a lot. If I had to pick one, I would probably say doing the play this past year. It was Miracle on 34th Street, and I just recently got back in the theater, and I wish I had done it a lot sooner and hadn't been scared what people had thought about me, but that was for sure one of the best experiences I've had here at Henderson County High School.
Ladies and gentlemen, Tyler Johnson.
Contestant number 10 is Will Thomas, aspiring Forker. Will is the son of Alicia Sheridan and Tommy Forker. He is a member of FBLA and the Y Club. He is a student ambassador, a CTE ambassador. Also serves as external president for Colonel's Corner Bank. After graduation, Will plans to attend UK to major in biomedical engineering. His favorite color is green, and his most recent binge, Drive to Survive. Fun fact about Will, his initials, WTF, which he thanks his mom. Will's idea of a perfect day is to go on an adventure and then watch a movie. All right, Will, if you would. How has being a part of the Mr. Colonel show impacted your life?
Well, obviously it's made me a little bit more confident. I just sang in front of all y'all, something I normally don't do. But it has boosted my confidence just a little bit, and I really appreciate it for that.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you would, a big hand, Will Thomas Turner. By his lovely stand-in, Leah Newman, for his lovely mother, Jennifer. Contestant number 11 is Boone Thomas, extravagant McElroy. Boone is the son of Douglas and Jennifer McElroy. He is a member of the Colonel's soccer team. This fall, Boone plans to attend the University of Mississippi and pursue the pre-law track. He is fond of the color red, and his zodiac animal happens to be a goat. Fun fact about Boone, he has split his head open multiple times as a toddler, which explains a lot about current day Boone. Recently, Boone binged watched The Punisher, and his idea of the perfect date, late night cruise, and some good old fast food. Boone, if you would. Describe a valuable life lesson you are taking with you as a graduate of Henderson County High School.
So a valuable life lesson that I'm taking with me is for sure to just be myself when everything comes together. Like whenever I'm up in front of a crowd, just like this, and I just know to be me, because if I'm not me, then I'm not who I want to be. And that's how I want to go through life.
Ladies and gentlemen, by his lovely mother, Susanna. Contestant number 12 is Dylan Dion Dedicated Moore. He is involved in FBLA, NTHS, Skills USA, Student Ambassadors, CTE Ambassadors, and Leadership Dynamics. He serves as Region 1 FBLA President, Henderson County High School FBLA President, and the Henderson County High School Skills Vice President. Following graduation, Dylan will attend USI to major in business, administration, and minor in human resources. Dylan enjoys exercising, playing with his Australian shepherds, and working when not involved at the high school. His favorite food is currently spaghetti Alfredo. His favorite color is blue, and he most recently binge-watched the Netflix series Manifest. His idea of a perfect date would include eating at an elegant restaurant, then going stargazing. Fun fact about Dylan, he used to be an avid hip-hop dancer, as we saw tonight. Dylan, if you will. Describe yourself in song lyrics.
Don't stop till you're on top.
There you go. Ladies and gentlemen, Dylan Dion on the board. Escorted by his lovely mother, Candace, contestant number 13 is Drew Aaron Loyal Kaser. Drew is the son of Candace Yates and Terry Kaser. Drew is a member of the criminal law classes here at Henderson County High School. This past summer, Drew completed his basic training and is already a member of the Army National Guard. Immediately upon graduation, Drew will follow his dad's footsteps and continue his career with the Army National Guard as he leaves to be stationed for Fort Leonard Wood in Missouri. Please take a moment to note that Drew is in his official dress uniform as a tribute to his late friend Ron. His favorite color is black, and his most recent binge watch series, MTV series Scream. His idea of a perfect date would definitely include scary movies, if you will. What does it mean to be a colonel?
I think to be a colonel, it means that you have to respect everyone and everything. Always be there for every student, no matter if they're good or bad. You gotta always be there for them. And you gotta overall be supportive and respect no matter what.
Drew Aaron Kaser. That is contestant number 13, and that is the conclusion of tonight's formal competition. We are glad that you were able to see each of the contestants looking so sharp tonight, and they did, and I thought the answers were fantastic.
How about that? How about bringing in a microphone that works?
Yeah, how about that? That was a big deal there. Yeah, exactly.
It was pointed the wrong way, but that's okay.
That's quite all right. What do we have? What's coming up? I don't have anything here in front of us.
I don't know. We should ask the crowd. No, I'm joking. No. That, my friends, concludes the competition. Okay. We're going to take a brief intermission. We're going to escort the judges out because we have some tabulating that needs to happen. So we can clear path, bring up some lights. Everybody, make sure you take this last opportunity to donate to the best legs and see where we go with that.
Yep. Maybe check the concession stand for a little bit, and we'll check back in about.
We're going to close the QR code voting as well so that we can roll into some awards. Can we do a time check? How are we doing, Steve?
Right now, we're at 7:24.
What? Okay, so lights up, intermission. We'll see you back in a few.
All right, folks, take care. Miss Snowball with the awards tonight will be co-directors of the show, Jaden Powell and Jordan Troutman. After the announcement of the winners, we would like for all the contestants to remain on stage for pictures. No one goes home empty-handed as we have curtain, please. It's all about rehearsal, guys. Don't miss it.
Have one. Curtain. And now, your...
Here they are! Of course, no one goes home empty-handed, as all are winners. With that, I will reach into my left pocket and pull out a gaggle of gifts. There's one set.
Ta-da!
And another set.
I didn't have pockets. So, tell them what they're getting, Steve.
Okay, each contestant tonight is receiving a car wash token to receive a free car wash from Rideout's Car Wash on South Green and a coupon to Henderson Nutrition. And another gift that was just added just moments ago, the winner of this competition, after they come on the Steve Town Morning Show tomorrow, keeping up with the Colonel's Friday Morning Edition, at 6:30 a.m.,
You get a free breakfast sandwich from, no. Don't cut me off, guys. You get a free meal. Don't cut me off. From our friends at Chef What Barbecue and More, Mr. Josh and Amy Bennett. Thank you. All right. You may have noticed the chicken leg buckets in the lobby. Those buckets traveled around the cafeteria, and the student body were given the opportunity to vote for the best legs with a penny a vote system. The votes have been counted. The best legs winning package includes.
Wait for it. Here she comes.
As we speak. All right, there we go. Our lovely assistant, Jordan, thank you. A KFC bucket full of socks and slides from Tip Top, a can koozie and sticker from Sweet Peas, a class of 2022 hoodie from Johnston's, and a fresh fried chicken legs from the Dodge store. The best legs of the night go to Travis Herndon. Have you seen his legs in real life? On Stage Award, this award is given to the contestant that showed the most sincere, well-thought-out answer to the question that was drawn out of the bowl. The winning package includes a bucket of fun to clean his car, donated by Fiberboard, $25 cash from Dr. Jennings, a gift certificate to the marketplace here at school, a free smoothie from Henderson Juice Company, $20 cash from Friel's Machine, and a bouquet of flowers, compliments of Shaw's Flowers. This prize package goes to Travis Herndon! Welcome to the Travis Herndon Show. It's been a big waste of time the last 90 minutes. We were just going to give everything to Travis in the first place. All right, next up, I know you're on the edge of your seat for the Fitness Award. This award is given to the most outstanding performance tonight as chosen by the judges. This fabulously fit young man will get a haircut at Sweet Beauty, a free smoothie from Henderson Juice Company, $25 gift card to a choice restaurant from Dr. Paige Warren, DMD. Also, a big brick of soap and loofah from Sweet Peas and a $10 gift certificate to Henderson Nutrition and the LED cornhole board donated by Escalade Sports.
Look at that.
As you can see right here. So, the winner, H.B. Hazelwood. The next award is Mr. Congeniality. This award was voted on by our contestants this evening. The winning package includes a $25 gift card to Palmer's Gas Card, a Duke Cannon chapstick, and a pair of socks from Sweet Peas, a Colonel's Cooking Crazy's lunch, and a mini cooler since he kept his cool throughout the whole experience, according to the contestants. Tonight's Mr. Congeniality is Drew Kayser! The Crowd Favorite Award. The results are in, and you, the crowd, have voted on using the QR code on your program. And we know that you picked as the crowd favorite tonight.
He receives a prize package that includes two tickets to Showplace Cinemas, a Colonel's Cooking Crazies lunch, and a $50 Sureway gift certificate. The crowd's favorite is Xander Wilson! Now we have the Mr. Smarty Pants Award. Scholastic achievement. Earlier this evening, the judges reviewed the transcripts of the contestants, and after careful deliberation, they selected this young man as the Smarty Pants of the bunch. Winning package includes the Henderson County High School academics fees being waived, a $15 gift card to Rookies, a candle from Sweet Peas, and a College of His Choice sweatshirt, and a Columbia backpack. Tonight's Mr. Smarty Pants is Dylan Moore! Next, we have the Talent Award. The judges were asked to carefully select the contestant who shined in the category of talent. The winning package includes two tickets to Showplace Cinemas, a t-shirt, a drawstring bag, and two face masks from the Dance Factory, two free meals from Arty's, and a Visa gift card from Independence Bank. The winner, Travis Herndon! From Colonel's Cooking Crazies, two tickets to Showplace Cinemas, one prom ticket, who's writing these? All right, $25 cash donated by Bill Heath's Family Sports and a $25 cash donated by KT Williams Law, LLC. Your second runner-up is Boone McElroy! $155 includes two tickets to Showplace Cinema, one free lunch from Arby's, a Marketplace sweatshirt, one free lunch from the Colonel Cooking Crazies, one prom ticket, $25 cash donated by KT Williams Law, LLC, and $50 donated by Hometown Roots. Your first runner-up goes to Travis Herndon! Is worth, well, priceless. Free basketball ticket to the game of your choice provided by the athletic department, one reserved parking spot, two prom tickets, one free lunch from Arby's, a free school yearbook, a Marketplace sweatshirt, two tickets to Showplace Cinemas, $100 cash, and a medal that you see here to proudly wear at graduation. Ladies and gentlemen, yo, class of 2022, Mr. Colonel is Tyler May.
Already have
a
reserve.
Who did you buy that one?
Hey, what they said.
What?
Right. The big thing is, Ms. Snowball, you want to say for them not to clear out of here in just a moment because we want to get pictures, right?
Right. We need a picture for the yearbook. We need a picture with the Leadership Dynamics class. One more round of applause for those students.
The participation of our judges, Kyle Forrester, Josh Bennett, and of course, Dr. Michelle Chappelle. Give them a big round of applause. Thank you so much. Ms. Snowball, this is our third Mr. Colonel event in as many years, and it just gets better every year.
I think so. We make notes and we'll tweak and we'll work on some things like sound, and we'll get things taken care of.
All right, thanks so much for attending this third annual Leadership Dynamics Mr. Colonel content. Once again, thanks to all of our sponsors and volunteers. I want to thank our friends at Gallery Gifts and Bridal, Ms. Pam Fister and Clark, for allowing me to have, because I don't look this good normally, I promise you on that, ask my wife. But again, thank you so much for that. Again, thank you to all of our sponsors. And again, be safe out there. Thanks for coming tonight. God bless everyone. Thank you.
Okay, ready?